My friend did it the other day, but it was so messy. I just tried to attempt to do it myself. I like my hair tied up, so this is why I decided to do it like this. Yeah, my friend put new extensions in. But I've just been loving how to braid my hair and it's out of my face. Yeah, but I've watched this YouTube girl and she attempted to do it on her own. And she made it look so easy. It's pretty good for my first time. So I'm kind of into that. So yeah, not bad for my first time, I have to say. Anyways, you guys, I hope you guys like this tutorial. I decided to do this super fierce look today. I just love it. Yeah, and I did a banging wing liner. I just love. And today is the first day I actually decided to do lip gloss because I am back at work and I can't wear lip gloss with a mask and I have to wear a mask at all times. So I've just been doing a matte lip and I was so excited to put a gloss on today. Yeah, and I love this combo. It's like super nude, but not, like it's pretty nude, but I love it. Yeah. Anyways, you guys, I hope you... Oh, I think I lost my last account. Seriously, I think I did. Oh, well, I'll fix it later. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun filming this tutorial for you guys. I had a lot of fun. Yeah, I hope you guys really do enjoy this video. If you want to keep on watching and get this look, yeah, keep on watching. What am I saying? Yeah, I have so much stuff to do now that I'm back at work. I just wanted to film for you guys and have fun. And I know you guys love when I film tutorials. So yeah, until next time. And for my next tutorial, I was thinking of doing like playing with some Swarovski crystals, just putting it in the corner. Yeah, I'm gonna have fun. That'll probably be next week. Anyways, you guys, I love you so much. Until next time. Peace. Bye. And don't forget. Love you, just stay. It's really hard to wear a freaking mask. Yeah, I have like a really hard time breathing, but my mom told me like I don't have to wear it all the time, just when I'm talking to clients and I wear gloves. Definitely adjustment when you're working in a salon. I don't know. I don't get why we opened because like you're so close. Although my mom was coughing yesterday and my boyfriend messaged me, he has a sore throat because he was supposed to come over today. I was like, that's not good. But I'm still fine. I'm actually glad I got back to work because I have my routine down. I just can't go to the gym yet. But everyone said I lost weight. Anyways, we're going to start this video. This is going to be my fierce makeup tutorial. Yeah, this is basically my go-to fierce makeup tutorial. I'm gonna do like a banging wing eye, but like a subtle champagne smoky eye. I always love doing champagne smoky eyes. I'm just putting this Capri lip glossy just because my lips are really dry, so they're better. Yeah. Oh yeah, it feels so good. So good. Yeah, that's basically it. My friend put some new extensions in, some of the fusions, and he braided it. It's a little messy, but I'm just gonna keep it up. Just the purpose of the video, because it's out of my face. Love it. And I'm just gonna use this Morphe Continuous Setting Mist just to like basically rehydrate everything because I'm dry. And ignore my nails. I am going Wednesday, so I booked with my girl. She was really busy, so, and also they close on Sunday, but my mom said she could watch the front for me. Yeah, because she's quick and she only takes an hour. So, and my nail girl, I was going to go somewhere else, but I was like, she's so good. I can't. I just can't. So, we're going to start this look with the Jaclyn Hill palette. What's new? We're going to do a really basic look today. It's pretty basic, but it's more like the wing liner is going to make the look fierce. So, I'm going to go in with Silk Cream. I love this color. I know I need more. Definitely gotta do another order, but I still have some colors in this palette. I'm gonna go in with the Morphe R37. This is from Morphe's Rose Gold collection. I always love this brush starting in with any transition color. It's just like, it's so fluffy and it's a gold hair. It just spreads the transition color really, really good. Okay, so we're just gonna put this all over the crease. Just like this, just a really light wash of color. I want to do a wing liner today because I haven't really been doing wing liners. Yeah, I don't know. I just want to be fierce today, you know? I hate it. Just like this. I'm just going to use this Fenty Pro Filt'r Instant Retouch Setting Powder in the shade Butter. I've been loving this shade recently because I usually use the vanilla one, the lavender one, but I've just been loving the finish of this. Also because, I don't know, I feel like the lavender is for really, really pale people right now. I'm pale, but not albino pale. I just think this gives it more flattering under eye for my shade of paleness. What am I saying? I don't know what I'm talking about. I haven't really been filming when I'm working, just because like I'm talking throughout the video and like usually I want to like pay attention for you guys, what I'm doing, what I'm saying. And in the morning, I'm like always in a hurry. Like the other day, I was in such a hurry. I stubbed my toe. I ripped my toenail off. I told my boyfriend, he's like, does it hurt? I said, it just ripped the nail, like the free edge. Didn't actually rip the nail bed. But yeah, when I was in quarantine, I had the time to film for you guys every day. That was my thing. And now I have to work, make money to get all my makeup. But yeah, that's like basically what I'm doing. I'm actually like really glad to be at work, you know? No, I just like, you know, I don't know. I was sleeping in a lot. I was going to bed at like 5 a.m. sometimes, like up really late. I don't know. But it's just not my thing. You know, like, and you waste your whole day. So I just, like, I'm not really into it. Mainly, it's just me, my mom, and my coworker, Adam, who's also my friend, who have been at work. All the rest of the staff, they don't want to come to work. I don't get why. They just want to be at home. Like, I'd rather be working, making money. So I'm going to go in with this peachy shade. This is from MFDO. This is going to be a really pretty transition color. And I'm going to use the Morphe M441. This. I love this brush because it's like more of a stiffer brush and it's more dense and it spreads the color more concentrated onto the eye. And plus it's like more narrow, I could really get into this inner corner here. Ta-da! Okay, now I'm going to go in with the shade Pukey. Today I want to go to Winners. I don't know. They just opened yesterday, but a few of the clients told me there's a huge line to the end of Canadian Tire. And I was like, bitch, I'm not going today. But hopefully, I want to go. I want to buy some new sweaters. I mean, I usually buy Lululemon pads. I'm just putting this pinky color everywhere. But since I'm not going to the gym, I don't really have the need to buy Lululemon. But I just want to buy new sweaters, you know? Place this right over top. I love this pinky shade. It just has such a beautiful color. It's like really rich and warm and pinky. Just like this. I'm kind of like, when I have no more product, I kind of like pull it up just to get that eyebrow corner because I want a really like soft brush of shadow. I want it to be really blended. Okay, now I'm going to use the Morphe 433. I don't want to use a super dark brown today. I'm just going to use the shade Mocha. Because it's not chocolatey, but it's like a light chocolate, which I've really been into using this color instead of a darker brown. I just find like it's not too harsh. If I want to do a really smoky eye, then maybe do a darker brown, but I'm really into this color. It's just really soft and it blends really nicely with the transition colors that we applied earlier. I haven't filmed in so long. I was like, I feel nervous, you know, but I always miss you guys and talking about makeup. I've been doing, like, on the days I go back to work, I've been doing, like, a lot of looks, like, new looks that I can film for you guys, just testing it out. I did this one the other day. I did, like, a really dark, smoky eye, but with, like, glitter. It was really pretty, and I did this a silver glitter smoky eye, which I'm super excited to film for you guys. I've just been trying different looks, to see, like, what you guys will like, because I love filming for you guys. Also, like, I love that you guys give me new ideas as well. So I'm just blending that out. I kind of want, like, a smokiness, but not too smoky. That would make sense. Yeah. Okay, I'm just going to take that M441, the second brush we were using, and going to go back in with that pinky shade again. And I'm just going to use this for blending that darker shadow because it's looking a little choppy to me, and I don't want to look choppy. I'm just blending it up here. Okay, now I'm going to use the MAC 242 brush. I love this brush. And I'm going to go with more of a champagne color. I'm going to use Obsess and SBN. And I always use these two colors together because Obsess is a little, it's more of a light champagne. And then SBM is like a bronze kind of champagne. And I love mixing them together. They make the perfect color together. I'm just going to spray this with some setting spray. I'm using this Too Faced Hangover RX 3-in-1. I got this in my FabFitFun box. Yeah, so it's a replenishing primer and setting spray with coconut water, probiotic base ingredients and skin reviver. So it's silicone free, alcohol free, and oil free, which if you're a dry girl like myself, alcohol is not your friend, y'all. So I'm just going to put this right in the inner corner. Yeah, and I love Too Faced products because they use a lot of coconut water in their products, which coconut water is really replenishing and hydrating for the skin. And the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, it also has coconut water and hyaluronic acid, which hyaluronic acid is a dry girl's best friend, let me tell you. And I love, like, the Too Faced Born This Way foundation is super, like, I don't know, it makes my skin look dewy and I love it. And that's basically my favorite foundation. I like the Dior one too. It's a little more full coverage, but that's okay. There is gonna do the other eye. Yeah, that's really pretty. When we put the liner, it's gonna look good. Now, I don't know, it's looking a little bit choppy and not as blended, so I'm just going to go back in with the shade Mocha, and I'm just going to use that same M433 brush. I'm just going to blend it with that shimmer a little bit more. I always do this in every video because it looks way more blended, and I don't want to lose that smokiness that we created. So just like stamp it over top and kind of like move the brush side to side. And just make sure it's not like choppy in that outer corner, especially by the tear duct. Not tear duct, but outer tear duct. Is that what you call it? I don't know, I'm blending. Just like that. Perfect. And we're gonna do the other eye. Okay, now we're just gonna go back with the shimmer using Obsess and SBN using that MAC 242 brush because we kind of lost that shimmer when we put that pukey color blending that brown color. I can't even think. Just like lightly stamp it over top, kind of blending it together. See, that's so much better than this one. You don't want anything to be choppy. Hangover setting spray, I'm just patting it into the skin because it's looking a little cakey under there and I don't want it to look too cakey. Just saying. Okay, we're gonna move on to the lower lash line. I'm gonna use this brush. This is the Morphe E18 from their Elite collection. I love using this for my under eye as the first shadow. And then we're gonna go in with Pukey. And just kind of blend that out. Just connecting that top line with the bottom line. Okay, and then I'm just gonna grab this Kylie brush. I'm just gonna use this MFEO color. I just want that lower lash line really blended. It's all, and this is like a really pretty peachy shade. And because we're doing a fierce, smoky wing liner, we want it to be an Uncle Fester vibe. Like, really, like, dramatic on the top and lower lash line. This is just my vibe. Like that. Okay, now we're going to do some liner.
My voice. Oh, my God.
I did just wake up. When I wake up, my voice is so raspy for some reason. I don't know why. I'm going to use this MAC Cosmetics Pro Longwear Fluid Line in the shade Blackjack. I love this eyeliner. Okay, where are you? And then I'm just going to use this liner brush from Morphe. This is the M443. I'm putting liner on first because I kind of want it to be smoky when we blend a dark shadow on underneath the lashes, the lower lash line. That's what I'm doing. Okay. Now, I'm just going to grab this definer brush. I'm using the Morphe M423. And we're just going to grab a mocha again. And we're just going to blend that liner and that lower lash line. Basically, smudge it all together. I know, I have my mouth open, but it's so hard to, like, apply anything on the lower lashes without your mouth open. I don't know why. There you go. Just go like that. Okay, perfect. And then I'm going to grab this Morphe from the Rose Gold Collection. This is the R41. And then I'm going to grab... And then I'm going to grab Pukey. Just because, blend that out. I kind of been digging doing a ombre lower lash line for some reason. Like, I'll use Pukey, and then I'll use a lighter color, and then I'll do the darker color, and then I'll use Pukey again, and then I'll do a lighter color. I've just been, like, digging this ombre effect. I don't know. It's my vibe. I don't know, and also, like, you want to do the same thing what you do on the top of the lash. That's my bad. Okay, now we're going to use that Kylie brush again. And I'm going to go in with MFEO, this really peachy shade. And this. Kind of blend that out. My chin's itchy. Okay, now we're just going to put more of that butter setting. Ooh, I dropped my eyelash glue. That's butter. Fuck, I can't even think. Setting powder, oh my God. We're just gonna perfect it a little bit. Light. I'm just gonna use the smudger dye. This is the Morphe M213. I'm just gonna go in with beam and in light. Or in light and beam. I love these highlight shades. And I'm just gonna lightly highlight the brow bone. Yeah. Oh,
honestly, I'm so excited to wear lip gloss today, you guys. Like, because I can't wear a lip gloss because I have to wear a stupid mask at work. Honestly, I wonder how long wearing a mask is for, because I swear to God, wearing a mask is going to kill everyone. Never mind the coronavirus. I don't know. I feel like if it's that unsafe, we shouldn't even go back to work. You know what I mean? And then, like, they say we have to make the clients wear it. It's just, like, annoying. Anyways, I'm going to use the Morphe M455. This is just this bullet guy. I love this brush for applying any inner corner highlight. I'm going to go in with a light and beam. Yeah, it's just, like, annoying more than anything. It's, like, yeah, you're that. And we're not allowed to serve drinks or, like, candy or, like, food anymore. It's just, ugh. Bitch. Like that, yes. I'm just gonna blend it with that smudger guy we were using earlier. It's a little too intense. Just wanna like blend it more, yeah. That's better. Okay, now. I'm just gonna take the under eye palette. It's so like muggy today. I feel like I'm dying. I have that fan on, so that's good. Okay, now I'm just gonna place some under eye powder. Which one do I wanna use? I think I'm just gonna use this one. This is the MAC Cosmetics shaping powder in the shade Emphasis. I know, I don't have much, but I did just make an order at MAC Cosmetics. I love MAC Cosmetics, but I don't order a lot from them. Just realized. I ordered a bunch of other stuff too. Like, I wanted this yellow eyeliner. I wanted to do a tutorial with the, a lot of my subscribers asked me to do one with the James Charles palette, and I wanted to add some jewels, something really fun. But I have to order the liner for it. I wanted to do a yellow liner. I've done the look with a white liner. It doesn't look the same. But I want to do like a really bright tutorial. I'll probably have that when I get it in. I got some MAC Fix Plus. What else did I get? I got like a red cream liner for when I do really bright shadows. I did that. There's a few other things that I got as well. I can't remember. Okay, now we're going to do some wing liner. Yeah, and I think I got some brushes, like just made up stuff. Okay, now I'm just going to move my mirror. I'm going to go back in with the MAC Cosmetics Pro Longwear Smooth Line in the shade of Black Track. Oh, and I got some glitter from MAC Cosmetics because MAC Cosmetics has the best glitters. Love Makeup Forever glitters, but you love something, you love something. Okay, I'm going to use this Royal Langnickel brush. It's actually a brow brush. I did use this Morphe one. I did not like it. I don't know, it's kind of like thick and it's not as thin. And it was really hard to apply eyeliner the way I do. But I guess this could be like a detail brush, but whatever. Okay. Just gonna draw a line. I gotta get comfortable here because I feel uncomfortable. I'm just gonna pull the skin. Yeah, and this brush, like, it just applies a thin line and I love it. If you're into thick liner, maybe that brush will be good, but I don't like it. Just being honest. Fuck. it's not very good, but don't worry, I'm gonna perfect it a little more. I don't know. I don't know, it's not perfect, but I'm gonna fix it. Like, I'll use just this flat guy just to kind of perfect it a little more. Like that. That's like okay. I'm not hating that. So we're gonna do the other eye. See, I'm telling you, I don't do the eyeliner I want, and I suck at it. And people tell me I don't. You're crazy. Also, like, I don't like using the felt tips. They don't last very long and they smudge. Also, I'm like a little shaky. My hands all dirty. I don't know, I'm weird like that. Okay, now, I don't know what kind of bronzer I want to use, but whatever. I'm just going to use the L'Oreal Luminous Lash of Paradise mascara. It's my favorite. Don't have to put lashes with this look, but I have to because my lashes are just so short. Okay, now I'm going to use the Flutter lashes in the style Intoxicating. These are the double lift lashes. These are my favorite. You guys can't really see. I'm just going to try it out first on my lashes, see how it looks. This look. Oh yeah, it's actually really pretty. I love it. Intense! Okay, where's my lash glue? Bitch, my eyes watering. Hey honeys, we're gonna contour. I'm gonna use this MAC Cosmetics sculpting powder in the shade Shadester. I love this color. I'm gonna use this Morphe R10. This is from their Rose Gold collection. I love it because it's like this cool dome shape and it just blends really nicely. But be careful because this contour shade is pigmented. Thank you. just be careful when you have eyeliner here. Don't like use your contour brush. It'll take off the eyeliner, then you have to fix it, which is not good. My lip is so itchy for some reason. I love this contour powder. It's such a pretty shade. It's like very bronze and golden. I love it. I'm going to take a clean brush because I kind of put too much on the forehead. It's like, bitch. Whatever. Who cares? Who cares? Okay. I think I want to use this MAC Cosmetics. This is the Mineralized Skin Finish Natural Powder in the shade Give Me Sun. I love this one. I love her. Okay, I'm just going to use this Morphe Tense Jaclyn Hill. This is the JH02. I'm going to use this brush because it'll kind of diffuse the contour a little bit. And because we did such a dramatic look with the eyes. I don't want a crazy bronzer or contour today. I don't know. This is my vibe. Okay. Now, I'm just going to bake. I'm going to use the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. I'm just going to put this on the jaw line. Perfect. Okay, now while that's baking, I'm just going to use that MAC Cosmetics Give Me Sun bronzer. I'm just going to contour the nose really quickly, just really lightly. And I'm using this Kylie brush. This is from her Christmas collection. This is just like a goat hair slanted brush, and I love using this brush. I hate when that happens. Yeah, I like that my bronzer and contour today is really like, I just want a light wash of color. It's not too dark. Okay. Oh my god. I'm going to use that MAC Cosmetics Shaping Powder again in the shade Emphasis. I just want to put this on the bottom of the jawline. I want it to match with the rest of the face. And it just adds for highlighting purposes, you know? I was going to go get wax today, but the location I go to in Yale Town is all booked up. I was going to go to Kitsilano, but I don't really want to take the bus right now. I feel like I'll get sick. I'll just shave if my boyfriend does come over. Half our problems. All right. Now we're gonna do blush, but I'm thirsty. I'm just gonna clean my hand a little bit. Okay, I'm going to go in with this Ofra palette. I've been loving this Ofra palette. I don't know. I love it for so many reasons. It's just so beautiful. And it's really pigmented. It's all vegan. I wonder what kind of blush do I want to do today. I'm thinking. Ooh, I don't think I've used this color. I think I'm going to use these two colors. They're kind of like rosy peachy. So this is in the shade Charm and Winter Rose Glow. It's kind of sparkly. I don't like really sparkly blushes, but it's like a light shimmer. This is my vibe. Just really lightly. And I'm using the Morphe E4. This is from their Elite Collection. I'm loving this blush brush. I don't know why. Like, look how pigmented that is. It's like kind of a bronzy, peachy shade. Now, we're going to put that away. Like, see how beautiful this blush palette is. It is a little bit expensive, but I think it's on sale right now because I think I only paid 70-something for it. But originally, it's like $100, but it is a really big blush palette. Okay, I'm going to go in with the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. I love this powder for diffusing the blush a little bit and just, like, adding an extra glow. And this is in the shade Luminous Light. I'm just gonna lightly add a glow. Just really lightly. I don't know what highlight I wanna use. I'm just gonna look really quickly. I'm gonna use this Kylie Cosmetics one. This is in the shade Queen Drip. It's kind of like a peachy rose. It's really pretty. My white hand doesn't even show up. Yeah, it's like soft. I'm into this. This is my vibe. You know what? I'm going to use a different brush today. A different highlight one because this one's a little wet still. Well, I'm gonna use this one. This is the Morphe Y14. Is this one? Yeah, this one's too wet for me to use right now. You stay there, honey. I've never used this one, so we'll see. Yeah, it's actually a really nice highlighting brush. Yeah. Okay, and then I'm just going to use the sponge, because I love using a sponge for highlight. And just lightly dab onto the cheeks. Yeah. I love Kylie's highlights because they're not super, like, they're, like, subtle, but they are buildable. Yeah, it's pretty. More. So that's this one enough for me. No me. Boozy. at me, baby. Okay. Now. We're going to do a different highlight because this isn't as beaming as I would like it. I'm just going to use the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Press Highlighter Champagne Pop. I just have to use Champagne Pop in everything because it's such a peachy undertone and I love it. I'm just going to lightly add cheek highlight. So excited to put lip gloss and lipstick. Are you kidding me? The shade Toy. It's like really peachy, which I'm going to do more of a peachy lip, nude lip today. Okay. Okay, honeys. Okay, that's looking really nude. What also lip do I want to use? Let me use Naked. So this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills liquid lipstick in the shade Naked. Yeah, it's really pretty. I love this liquid lip. So nude, I love it. Okay, I think I'm gonna use a Marc Jacobs lip gloss today. I'm gonna use this one. This is the Marc Jacobs Enamored High Shine Lip Liqueur in the shade Moonstone. It's also really pretty, just like a light pink. Oh, I love it. Love Marc Jacobs lip glosses. It's so weird to wear lip gloss, I'm telling you. Yes, okay. I'm just going to use that Morphe Continuous Setting Mist just to seal the deal. I'm going to use the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. This is a new bottle, so. I'm just going to glue those baby hairs, eyebrow hairs up. Now we're going to use some mascara. I'm just going to use the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. This is my favorite mascara for lower lashes I live. I think I have like some eye goop. It's better. Okay, I'm just gonna do my hair real quick. I'll be right back, you guys.
For this tutorial, I rebraided my hair. I've just really been into this vibe. I've actually never knew how to French braid in my hair, but I found this video of this girl and she did it in a different way that was easier, and just like watching her do it like was super, I didn't do it like perfect but pretty good. I could just never do like my own braids. I usually like to have my hair up when I'm doing groceries because like
I have it down, like, the, if I have groceries, it'll actually pull my hair, so that's why I like to tie it up. But yeah, that's it for this channel. I had so much fun filming this tutorial for you guys. I miss you guys so much, because right now I can only film, like, once a week. So yeah, I have my other video I'm gonna put up right before I leave the house for doing errands. But yeah, that's it for this channel. I hope you enjoy. Yeah, I had a lot of fun doing this video. Also, because I could wear lip gloss today. Just saying. Yeah, I love this look. It's definitely fierce. It's definitely me. I feel like I braided my hair, my face. I definitely have a facelift, but I'm okay with this. I always, like, curl my hair, but this is, like, the first time I haven't. I've just really been into, like, these braids. I just love it that it's, like, up, but not up, but you know. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun filming this tutorial for you guys. For my next video, I might do, I don't know. I honestly don't know what my next video is going to be. I wanted to play with some Swarovski crystals, so I might do that for my next channel. I don't know. I was into this, and I think I might do it in the inner corner and do kind of like a smoky brown eye just to be different. We'll see. I have a few looks in mind. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I had so much fun filming. I love you. I have so much things to do today, so I'm going to let you go. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm out here alone in churning water. The clear air tells me there's a storm coming. I'm not afraid of the dark cloud, gonna wait it out. Got me racing my heart now and I'm fading out. I'm waiting to be to be. I need to know that I'll be